with you, to support you, to be proud of you, and to remind you that love isn't happily ever after. Love is the experience of writing your story. You fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You both are choosing each other.
Family and friends of Bridget and Colin, welcome to Kinkell Byre. It's wonderful to be with you last night, and for anyone who didn't meet me, my name is Kate, and it's an honour and pleasure to be here today to celebrate the marriage of Bridget and Colin. Bridget and Colin have chosen to share their love with each and every one of you. So therefore, on their behalf, I would like to thank you all for coming to celebrate this long-awaited special day, but I suspect you wouldn't have missed it for the world.
Cause this is not an endless game. I'm drawn to every word you say.
So, first and foremost, it is incredibly heartwarming that you are all here. It is humbling to see how many of you have managed to make it. We have representation from all over the world. So we know what an effort is being for you all to get here, especially with travel being more anxious than it was maybe a couple of years ago. Some people have had to get passports to just be here today, especially for this ordeal with misconnecting flights, road closures, train delays. So really, truly, thank you all of you for being here.
Take me to the deepest down.
Unfortunately, it's not been possible to have everybody we love here with us today. But we know that they're here with us in spirit, and they're not only in our thoughts today, but they're, more importantly, they're here with us in our hearts. So with them in mind, would you please be standing and raise your glasses and join me with the first toast to absent friends and family. Every time. Keeps the blood circulating. I wanted to say a special thank you to Marion and Billy, Bridget's parents. They are the honorary mayors of Woodlawn, even though they don't live there anymore. And without you, Bridget wouldn't be here. They've always joked that Bridget was ready to leave home by the age of 5, bags packed and everything. And I believe it too, because she's very independent. So I'd like to thank you for allowing and encouraging her independent nature. It is in no small part the reason why she is the wonderful feminist nomad that we know now. I'd also like to thank you for the support that you've given me over the years. I've been living in New York nearly 10 years now. And even though I just tied the knot with your daughter, I think you've been family for a long time. So thank you. And to that, I'd like everyone to stand up again. To the second toast, I want to make to family, be it birth, by birth, marriage, or those that you find along the way. To family. Bridget.
My name.
I love you. I don't say it to you half as much as I should, and even what I should say is half as much as you deserve. There are many qualities that I admire in you. You are aspirational. You're a dreamer. You are fierce, you are smart and independent. And you are incredibly empathic and moral. If I had to sum our relationship up in a word, it would be fated. We met at my sister's wedding. You were only able to turn up at last minute with like 2 days notice. And you didn't have any accommodation, so you had to stay with us. And that's how we first met. We then had to be long distance for a couple of years, and we were talking every day over the internet before the pandemic made it cool. The first time I was to fly out to New York to see you, I found out a week before that my passport was missing. But thanks to friends, family, and the stars aligning, I was able to come out and see you and your friends and family. And there are many other times we have followed, many other times where we have managed to follow the golden path where we are together instead of not. At every moment where there's been difficulty by luck, opportunity, or effort, we have managed to come out the other side together, especially over the last couple of years where the pandemic has forced us to stay 24/7 in a tiny apartment. The opportunity for us to grate on each other, to fracture or split under the pressure, was really high. But it did the opposite to us. Being around you all the time made me like you more, if that's possible. We rose to the occasion, got to know each other more than we ever could imagine. So with all that in mind, I can't actually read anymore because I'm crying. But with all that in mind, here are some promises I'd like to give to you from now until the ever after. I promise to always try and make you snort laugh with stupid jokes, especially when we're in company. I will support you when things get overwhelming, emotional, or stressful. I promise to tell the truth whenever you ask me how you look. Though my answer will always be that you're beautiful. I promise to let you know every time I hear heavy rain or thunder so that we can listen to it together. And I will do everything I can to make the things that are most important to you important to me as well, even if I don't understand their value. And even if it means I need to rummage around in a bin to get it. Bridget, I love you. We should get married.
We should.
Bridget, with this ring, I thee wed.
Bridget, with this ring, I thee wed.
My love and respect I give you.
My love and respect I give you.
And all my worldly goods I share with you.
And all my worldly goods I share with you.
This is a story all about how my sister Bridget made us all proud. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there and tell you how she fell in love with this freak with red hair. In Woodlawn, New York, she was born and raised. McCortland Playground is where she spent most of her days. So chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool, hanging with Heather and Jackie after school. When we were just kids, we were up to no good. Started causing trouble for our sisterhood. We got in too many fights, and our ma got scared. She said, "Pray the Lord Jesus, put my girls in your care." Bridget whistled for a cab, but when it came near, the year was 2007. She is single as her status. If anything, I could say that my sis was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, no hope for there. Then she pulled up to a wedding for Laura and Bob, and she yelled to the dance floor, "I think I'm in love. One look at his kilt," and she knew right there. She fell in love with a Bert with red hair.
Thank you.
What we have here is a blending of Scottish and American culture. So I look for references in literature and films and things about where this might have happened before, and I found a really interesting documentary called Braveheart. Now, I know the Scots in the room will love that. Now, it's a fascinating historical epic, but at its core, it's a story about love, courage, and a willingness to take liberties with historical events in order to tell a good story. So on that note, I will begin. Now, all good love stories have an origin story. So, I want to take you back a few years. Just imagine it, eyes meet across the room. There's a connection, they both know it. They're circling, almost a dance, bodies hot with sweat. And then suddenly one leaps for the other and grabs on tight, refusing to let go. And there, with my full 16 stone sweaty frame on his back, Colin performed a perfect squat before we both collapsed to the floor on our first kickboxing night of the year where we met at university. Now, when I started, I mentioned Braveheart, love and courage. Because the no-nonsense origin story of Bridget and Colin is so really resonates with me, love and courage. Because as we've heard with the vows today, from a chance meeting at a wedding in Brazil, to a long-distance relationship, to Colin coming to me one day and saying, I'm giving up my house, I'm giving up my job, I'm gonna give up most of my possessions, and I had to help him enter his liquor cabinet, that's all right. I'm moving to America to make a go of it. And that took a lot of love and courage, and that's what we're here celebrating today. Woo! So to finish off, it's always tradition, especially in the UK, for the best man to give the groom some advice to help him get through marriage. So to that end, my first piece of advice is, Colin, don't use rickshaws, they're a scam. I included that one because it didn't really sink in the first time. And the second piece of advice is, relationships are give and take. It's a partnership. Set boundaries, agree who's boss, and then just do everything Bridget says. So to finish, I just wanted to finish on a quote from one of our favorite authors. And it's a very, very short quote, and it's simply to say, may all of your stories be glad ones, and your roads be smooth and short. So would everyone please be upstanding and raise a toast to... let's do this one. To our guest, the special people tonight, the bride and groom.
Colin, in The Thief of Time, Terry Pratchett wrote that against one perfect moment, the centuries beat in vain. There have been many times over the course of the last few years, from pandemic to stomach flu, where all the time and energy put into getting to this place, standing here with you, felt extravagant or trivial. But as we heard yesterday in Nora's naming ceremony, the odds of us being here at this exact place and this exact time are so great and so rare that they will never happen again. And as I think about the lifetime that beats against this moment, standing in front of the people we most love in the world to share how profoundly I love you, Colin hears, and that's one of the most non-trivial things I can imagine. From the day we met, literally the second I jumped into your arms to say hello and inform you we were dating, I felt a sense of peace and safety, my true north. In the over a decade since, you are the first person I want to share my triumphs and successes with, and the first person I call or sob at in times of hardship. You listen, you talk me through, you literally and often physically help me to breathe in times of anxiety. I'd be remiss to not mention how breathtakingly beautiful it's been to watch you become a father. The love Nora has for you and the care you give, plus all the plans you have for tiny nerdy feminist, I couldn't ask for anything more. Early on in our relationship, when we were sappy young folk who wrote long-distance love letters to each other, we ended one of our letters with a commitment. Let's try to be the great person behind each other. We've always been very deliberate in seeing a loving partnership as a choice you make every day, to share in the joys and good times, yes, but to wade through the tough times, the scary times, and to always be checking in with each other. It might seem unromantic, but choosing love every day means I have had the possibility to fall in love with you again and again, countless times, without reservation, often in newer, deeper, and surprising ways. And this I promise you in front of all those we hold dear. I vow to hold to our commitment to nurture, uplift, and support, to be your biggest cheerleader, to ensure your needs and wants are essential to all decisions we make in our lives. No matter what course we set, we will do it together. I vow to play Dungeons and Dragons at least once, and to give it my all. I vow to watch every Nick Cage movie, even the newer weird ones, happily by your side, and binge fantasy sci-fi series with snacks for the rest of our days. I vow to love who you are now and who you are yet to become, to listen and learn from you, respecting, loving, and trusting you, for I know that together we will build a life far better than either of us could imagine alone. I choose you knowing there are still many roads we must travel and mountains left to climb. I choose you to struggle and succeed with, to fight and make up with, to love and grow old with. I believe in nothing more assuredly than the truth of who we are together, and I will love you for the rest of my days with every beat of my heart and long after that.
That I love you the most. I love.
The universe brought you closer together 11 years ago, and you've honored that gift every day since. Now grounded in the beauty of this place, surrounded by the people who love you endlessly, I'm so happy to pronounce you publicly for the first time married. As you kiss, may your spirits be bound in lasting love and joy. First kiss. You may kiss.
Fair fire, your honest, sunsy face.
I've always been afraid. I've always been the one on the outside. Bring it out of me. Hold up. Always been the one to make a left, not go right. With a matinee in a late night show.
Diego Montoya right here, who knows? If you kill that vibe, then prepare for them blows. I be on my own dip, man. Stupid all hit, cooking up a cook-up, charging for a mixed shit. You ain't even listening, I'ma keep the listening.
Well, I'ma make moves, just listen.
You lost. Away we go.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. With a matinee in the late night show.
Oh,
with a matinee and a late night show.
I've been trying to write this part of the speech for the best part of 2 years now. And it's been really difficult. How do you pin down Bridget with things as silly as words? How do you describe something that is ineffable as Bridget Burns? So instead of trying to make the ineffable effable, I thought I'd eff it and tell a story. When we first met, at my sister's wedding, Bridget found a green feather. And to normal people, this would have just been a green feather. But to Bridget, this was a magical thing. This was definitely something with arcane power and mystery beyond all recognition. And this shows how Bridget is such a wonderful dreamer, and she can imagine and make real the world around her. And I was caught up with this so truly that I believed it as well. But we were walking one point in Brazil, and she threw away some trash into a bin and accidentally threw the feather in the bin as well. And when I'm saying that this bin was hot and steaming and juicy and just disgusting, but the feather was in there, and it was a magical thing and it was powerful. So we needed to get it. So I got it. This is the dedication. I hope that we have given each other over the years, and that I will give to you continually for the rest of our time. Unfortunately, when we moved house once, the green feather went missing. And that was a sad day, because this was a wonderful, powerful thing that I shook my arm in a really bad bin for. But I may have, if it hasn't fallen out of my spot, I may have found a similar feather. So finally, my final toast is to you. My beautiful bride, I love you. Thank you.